If it's true that police at Keke Beach, where the ill-fated boat cruise began its journey, attempted to persuade revelers that it was not safe, then one wonders why none of them had the sober mind to listen, or had they gone tipsy already? But even in that mode, some people would have considered their safety and demanded from the boat crew an explanation to dismiss the argument put forward by the police that the boat had been repaired very fast, having been lying there in despair for over 3 months. The State Minister of Works and Transport, Vincent Bagire, told media that owners of the boat had hidden it on learning that Marine Police were planning to impound it. Does this imply that the dead couple knew that they were breaking the law by luring people to their cruise boat? But on the other hand, why did police not coordinate the arrest if it is true that they wanted to save lives? With all the explanations and excuses given, one question emerges. Do Ugandans, especially those in influential positions, have respect for the country's laws and the police who enforce law and order? According to survivors on the cruise boat, many revelers, including those who did not know how to swim, refused to wear life jackets. It is in the same manner that it is only in Uganda, in the region, that border passengers hardly accept to wear helmets. When it comes to commuter road transport, the situation is not any better. Very few Ugandans use the seat belt as a measure to ensure their safety. Ugandans may not boycott a taxi whose seats have protruding rusty metals that may either pierce them, causing them tetanus, or tear their nice and expensive clothes. Report by Emmanuel Lubega for Urban TV.